we ready to make our escape?
Not ours. My.
It's one of those things where it'll hit me when it actually occurs, because it, at times it seemed like it would never happen, but it's great. I'm glad it's premiering. I'm looking forward to it.
There was just an excitement that was building. Odyssey Through Time, it was going to be the biggest thing we've ever done, and everybody was really psyched for it. So now that it's finally premiering, it's a good feeling.
Odyssey Through Time is finally here. Several months before the filming, staff and students started extensive production work. Plans were drawn up for soon-to-be elaborate sets and detailed miniatures.
My name is Justin V. Scalapland, and for the movie Odyssey Through Time, I helped build the ships and other special miniatures that were required.
Each spaceship contains minute detail and took approximately 2 months to be built.
With a wooden construction with matte board, just a type of cardboard, built over the top of it, and then anything we could find, just throw it on to add to the effect.
While the pre-production of the special effects was going on, the actors and actresses were preparing themselves for the challenging parts they would undertake.
We started out doing rehearsals. We rehearsed and got into our characters, got characterizations and things. We rehearsed every Friday night for about 2 months before we started.
Come June, everyone was ready to begin the taping of Odyssey Through Time. The sets were built, production on the miniatures was started, and the actors and actresses were ready. Most people had two jobs to do, both working with the technical side, and if they chose to, acting.
My name is Wendy Waldman, and I acted in Odyssey, and I was on technical. When I acted, I played an assistant to the scientific director or something of that nature, on the Plendower, which was the bad ship. And in technical, I did lighting and sound.
Now, I want you to be quiet. Your father worked late last night. He's trying to get some rest.
Hey, I'll have none of that talk in my house.
She was she was a real witch. She was very mean. She had this foster child, Doug. And the only reason she had Doug as a foster child was because she needed the money. It was on that lights and sound. I learned a lot that summer. It was the second summer I was here. It was a summer I think I learned the most.
Part in Odyssey Through Time, I played General Zordak, who was sort of, he was the villain of the film. He takes his followers, they're sort of revolutionaries in this world, and takes them through a black hole.
Tommy, what are the chances that Riker pursued us through the black hole?
The black hole? I doubt that. No, it's unlikely.
It was also unlikely that he would employ the self-destruct mechanism.
There's a wide variety of effects in Odyssey Through Time. In fact, this film has more effects than anything else we've ever done. We've sort of grouped them up into what we call beaming effects, where people transport from here to there. That involves animating a glow over an actor and then making them disappear as the glow zips off into space. There's also lasers, which are just colored lines or white lines that show up on screen for a couple frames. And then there's also all the miniature effects, the spaceships and the starbase and the space battles and that kind of stuff.
Now!
I was on the videography crew, and it was my first year being a videographer, and I was really nervous, and I really really messed up a lot in the beginning. We're talking really messed up here. Like, during the first video shop, the boss had to stand with me, and he had to help me work the camera. I was so nervous, and I really didn't do that good. But then during the second and third video shop, I had a lot of pressure put on me to do right, and they kept me on the beast for a long time until I was ready. And then the day Evening Magazine came, I had to get up and do a good job for Evening Magazine, and I got up and I did a good job. At least I think so. I hope so. That summer, we went on more excursions than any other year, with trips to Valley Forge, Willow Grove Naval Air Station, Willow Grove Mall, and Nockamixon State Park, to name a few. On the fifth video shop, we traveled for 3 days and 2 nights to Ocean City, New Jersey, and stayed at the Raleigh Hotel. The filming was now complete, but the film was far from being finished. Post-production work was now to start.
Currently, I am the editor of the production. Editing the scenes, I think, wasn't a problem. The scenes flowed real nicely, and it was basically assembling the scenes. When it comes time to put the film together, sometimes things that are written in the script don't always look as good as they sound in the script. So as it comes time now, where I'm doing the rough edit and the final edit, I have to sort out and kind of rearrange scenes and, creatively come up with the best way that the scenes are going to flow. And that's, I guess, the difficult part of editing. The average time for editing a scene would probably be somewhere from an hour to an hour and a half. It really does depend on the scene. You know, some scenes are long, like the fight scenes are, they take a long time. That might have taken me 3 hours. And then there's little short bites that may take a half hour. But on the average, I'd say about, 1 to 2 hours. Oh, I feel good that it's over with. I hope that everyone enjoys the film. I put a lot of effort into it, and I think it looks good. So we'll see what happens.